Okay, this is my 03 RX1 Snow Check Edition. RX1 Mountain. It hasn't been running very good, so I gotta clean the carburetors on it. It's been missing and flooding over. So I would just put it on here so that in case somebody else had the same problem, maybe they'll know how to do it. So it's in pretty good shape. Haven't wrecked it or anything, so anyway, first thing I do, gotta do is open the hood, of course. And I've already undone the screws, but or loosened the clamps, but under this flap right here, there's a set of clamps right there. You gotta loosen these screws right here. And then you gotta pull this strap right here. Then you can take the air box off. And it's got two hoses that connect it to the air box. One's right here. I've already pulled it undone. And another one right here. I've already pulled them up. They connect to here and here. I'm going to set this to the side. Next thing you got to do is you got to loosen all the clamps on the carburetors. And the ones on the airbox that held it right here, these were Phillips. The ones over here are hex, your T15 hex screws, T15 Torx screws. There's one on each one. You gotta loosen all those. Okay, then you gotta unplug this wire right here. It goes to the carburetor. And then I'm gonna see if I can lift it without undoing anything else. Hopefully I can do that without too much problem. Okay, the next thing I did, I found me a pry bar like this one here. Stuck it down in here. Got this side pried open, over. I got all the clamps loose. I don't want to undo any hoses because all I want to do is clean the carburetors. I think I can do it without. I think I'll put this down in here. Find me a good spot. There's a the electric. The vacuum hose right there. I'm gonna be careful not to get into that. Light a little bit. It's trying to fall down on me. Now, there we go. Got that side pried loose. So, carburetor is loose from the manifold, from the intake insulators. Now, let's see if I can lift them up. Yes, I can. So I undid that wire. There are a bunch of hoses connected. There's the fuel lines, the intake fuel lines, the throttle cable, and the overflow. But there's the bottom of the carbs right here. And that's my next objective. Take all those out. Okay, I was trying to do that. Couldn't quite turn it over because there's a wire tie right here. I'm gonna cut this wire tie. Same thing with keeping me from turning the carbs over. So all I'll do just flip them upside down without unhooking anything else. Oops, I just unplugged another wire, which is right here. But it shouldn't be too hard to figure out. Look at it to see if I want to undo the rest of the hoses so I can take it to a bench. It's much easier. Looks like all I have left to disconnect would be this vacuum hose here, this return line here, right here, and plug two wires right here. And then this intake fuel line, I'll probably just disconnect here and here. It'll probably be the easiest way, especially when I get ready to put it back on. Then it appears to have a drain hose right there. And I'll just pull that undone, and I'll be able to take that onto a bench and make it a lot easier, because it don't look like I'm going to be able to do it here. Okay, so I got the carburetor turned over so I can get to the take the float bowls off, but I had to remove this hose going to the antifreeze, going to the coolant. It's to warm the carburetor so they don't vapor lock, freeze up. But it's sitting there running all over, so I'm gonna put this bolt right here. It looks like the bottom of the carburetor is held on by normal Phillips screws. I'm just gonna go ahead and turn off the camera and take those out, and then I'll come back with the removal of the bolt covers. Okay, once you get all the 16 screws removed from the bottoms of the bowls, take the covers off like this. Carefully remove them, and you see there's a bunch of gunk in there. And this is the main jet. It's all clogged. This is a slow jet. It looks clogged too. And then you got to clean the needle and seat right there. There's the float right here. And then this is supposed to be an O-ring, but it looks like it's very deformed. So I'm going to have to put new O-rings here. Probably a good idea to keep all these in the same order. So I'm just going to place them all in a row. Next, what you need to do, get you a good screwdriver that's wide enough to go all the way across to both sides of the jet here. So, because if you break these brass fittings, you'll have to replace them. And I don't really think you need to replace them if you got something good to clean it with. And I've already got them loosened, so I should be able to unscrew them pretty easy by holding the camera too. Okay, I'm going to take these jets out. I'm just going to do one carburetor at a time. See, there's the jet right there. And I got this carburetor cleaner. Got this handy little basket in it. And I'm just going to put all the parts in that basket and let them soak for a little while. But you don't want to put any rubber parts in it, like the rubber O-ring that's right here. If you put it in there, it'll dissolve it, probably, and make it so it's no good. And it's already no good anyway. Anyway, that right there is all dirty and corroded. And then there's an O-ring right there. I need to take that rubber washer off. And I need to take that rubber O-ring off and take the top of that off before I put it in. And there's another jet right here. Need to remove it too. careful not to drop them inside. Might be hard to get them out. Especially since I'm not doing this on the bench. Thought I got that one out. This looks like the slow jet. And it's pretty mess, pretty corroded too. I'm gonna drop it right in the chem dip. And then I'm gonna remove the needle and seat. Let's take this screw out right here. Take the screw out right here. Be careful not to lose it. I've got a little bucket right here. I'm putting all my parts in so I can keep everything straight, and I'm only doing one at a time. The float, you don't want to put in the chem dip, and you don't need to. All you need to do is clean it off. It has a little spring on it. It's connected to the needle, which is on that side right there. And the seat is right there, and you have to remove that screw right there beside it to get the seat out and let that soak. And then I'm going to take some carburetor cleaner, and I'm going to spray it in all of the openings that I open, in all the openings right here and all the openings on this side of the carburetor. And then I'm going to blow air through it and make sure it's all cleaned out. And I'm going to do it one carburetor at a time just to make sure that nothing gets
going.
Take the
a big bucket.
And take the carburetor parts back to the carb cleaner. They should be cleaned by now. Mm-hmm. See, here's the jets in here. They've been soaking all this time.
And that's all jets.
Well, that was just for the first carburetor. I've got a clean paper towel. Wipe them off with this clean paper towel. Get all the junk off of them. It should be come out of the chem dip nice and clean. And I got this little tiny tooth flossing brush. First I'm going to try cleaning them out with it. See if I can get everything, because if I can get it all the junk out of it with this, then I won't have to use anything else. That's the best thing, to use something soft like this. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm doing? Mm-hmm. Clean out all the jets.
Simple.
What's that? These are just the ones out of the one first carburetor.
Mm-hmm.
But it's the same both sides.
Mm-hmm.
And I take the brush there and I blow it through them. But hold on to them good and tight so you won't lose them. And it holds up to a light. Look inside and you'll be able to tell if it's clean. That one's nice and clean. Set it there. Pull out this one. And look through this one. Nice and clean. Same thing with this one. This one's still clogged. So the clog was further than I could reach with that. So I'm going to take this part deal right here It's called the tip cleaner. It's for a settling torch. And I'm good. It's got a whole bunch of different sizes, little bitty files in it, is what they are. You want to be careful with them so you don't file and make it too big, makes it any bigger. Try to find the one that fits the best. Push it through. That one doesn't really fit. I've got another smaller one here. Try this one. You need to be able to take this tip cleaner all the way through the jet. If you don't have something like this, you can cut the bristle off of a wire brush or something like that too. It's usually enough. This one's clogged bad. I'm still not getting it with that. That one's still too big, maybe. Try this. I think this is the smallest one right here. Not positive. And you clean them all out.
Okay.
And then I take the carburetor and pull this O-ring off of here. And you don't want to clean it. I got all my stuff in this box. You take carburetor cleaner and you spray it in the bowl like this. And you take a brush. I got this toothbrush, it'll probably work pretty good. Clean it all out with this toothbrush. Get down in there as good as you can. Spray all that out.
Gosh, let's see how dirty that toothbrush is now.
I already removed the drain plug too.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Right, so I'll take the drain plug out. This is it right here. See how it drains out? That's how you drain the carburetors before you even start. I didn't show that part, but that's what you do before you start. This is the drain screw. It's got some junk on the tip of it, so I'm cleaning it off. Cleaning off the threads a little bit. Mm-hmm. Set it over here with the rest of the parts. Then I'll take some compressed air. We'll blow it through the drain plug hole. There, when you put it back together, it'll just clog up your jets again. You'll be right back where you started from. Seems all nice and clean in there now. I don't know how good you can see that, but
I can see it good.
Okay, I got the carburetor up here. I got me what I call a pipe cleaner, and where the needle and seat was at, I don't want to take the seat out very bad. Because it's in really good shape, but I want to make sure it's clean, so I'm just going to clean it out right here with this pipe cleaner. I sprayed some carburetor cleaner in it. I'll put some more. Make sure it's cleaned out really good, because if that sticks, carburetor will be flooding over and it won't run right, and that's what the problem was to begin with. So I want to make sure I got those clean. So I'm cleaning this part right here, make sure there's no varnish or anything that will make that needle stick from sliding up and down. Then I'm going to blow it out with compressed air. So you have to have the fuel line removed to do that. I don't know if I showed that part or not, but I got both the fuel lines removed. One there and one there. They lead to this right here, to the fuel pump. One leads to the top one leads to the bottom one. And in order to make sure you got that out, you gotta have that off, otherwise you probably just blow stuff inside the tube, and then when you start it up, it'll push back out into the needle and seat and plug it back up. I'm going to do one carburetor at a time. I got all the jets back in. Had to go to a store that sells seals and bearings. And I got new O-rings right here and right here for this, because they were all deteriorated. And I want them to work properly. Okay, now I got all the jets in this first carburetor. you can see. And I'm going to put the needle and seed in now. The needle has a little bitty spring on the top. I don't know if you can see it very well. This camera's not focusing on it very well. But anyway, there's a little spring on it. And it goes right on that little tank on the float. You have to hook it on there and then you drop it down into that hole. It's pretty hard for me to hold the camera and do this at the same time. But I'll see what I can do. See, I just hooked it on like that. See, it's hanging right there. And then I just bring it over. Set it down so that it falls into the hole, into the seat. And then this little pin right here has to go down here in place. But I have... Oh, okay. Just making sure I didn't feel right, so I was just making sure everything was all right on it. The floats, I believe they say top and bottom on them. And you got to make sure after you get done that the float shuts off so that they're right at a 90 degree angle. To march this way and it'll be too lean, you'll run out of fuel or starve the cylinder. Too much this way and it'll flood over or give you too much gas. Now all I got to do is put this screw in right here. Right into this hole and it'll hold it in place. Okay, and some of these jets were kind of dirty and air and carburetor cleaner didn't do the trick. So I have this tip cleaner for a welder, acetylene torch. Some people call it jet cleaners. They sell them on eBay as jet cleaners in different places. But anyway, they're what they are. There's a little wire. It's kind of a file on the end of it. Kind of hard to see, but you put it in there to clean it out, so you don't want to do it too much. You just slide it in here like this. Slide it into the jet, and then you just kind of gently rub it on the side a little bit to make sure there's no dirt in there. And then you blow it out with compressed air again to make sure there's no dust particles or anything. And that'll get all the gas, varnish, and stuff out of it. And when you're putting that back in the carburetor, you see right here the needle valve, that's for the throttle. It's right here in the center. And I didn't take the top off, so that's still in there. Because I can reach inside and I can push it down. I just push down on the slide. Make sure that you put it so that that goes inside the jet. Slide the jet in there and then you turn it in all the way so that it seats against that rubber washer. And an 8mm wrench fits on it. Let's see if I can find it. Then you just take the 8mm wrench and you just tighten it, snug it up just so that it doesn't leak. Just barely even tight, not real tight. But you just smash that O-ring out of there. And the other O-ring is right here. That fits into the hole in the float bowl on the cap of the carburetor right here. So you have to make sure that you take this, clean this hole out really good so that O-ring will fit in there because they're real tight. And if you don't, then when you slide this on, it'll cut the O-ring. And I'm going to put a little bit of motor oil on this one too when I put these back on so that it'll make sure it slides on. Just barely a coating of it. Okay, now that I got both of the floats in, I attached this piece of hose to the inlet pipe right here. It's got one for each two carburetors. And I'm going to put air through it so that I can check the float level and make sure that it's right. I'm just going to put a little compressed air in there. And I think I'll just do it with my mouth. Because it's a little bit too much pressure to do when I only have one hand to hold it with. Thank you. See, I can tell that that's the spot when I blow through with my mouth, that that's the spot where it opens up. So this one looks like it's just a little bit on the lean side. And the way you adjust that is you bend this little tang ever so slightly. And you do that until you get them just right. Okay, with a little bit of trial and error, I bent these little tangs right here and right here. And I did one, each one of them individually, until I got it so it shut off at a perfect 90 degree angle. And the way I found the 90 degree is I placed something right here on the edge of the float and measured it. Then I measured it right here so that it was the same measurement, front and back. And when it's the same measurement, then I have my 90. Okay, now I'm going to put a little bit of motor oil on the end of my finger. And just going to put a little bit right here on this O-ring. And on this one, just to make sure that I don't cut those O-rings when I put the bowl on. Got the bowl right here all cleaned out, ready to go. Just slide it on gently like this. And then put all four screws back in and do the same with the other one. Now right here on the bottom of the float bowl, there is a passageway that where the main jet gets the fuel from, and I stuck this pipe cleaner through it and I sprayed some carburetor cleaner and I work it back and forth just to make sure that's good and cleaned out. And after I do that, I'm going to blow it out with compressed air again to make sure that all the dust particles are out of there. And I've got the drain plug off and I blew air through there and put the Q-tip through that. This is the drain right here. It should have drained before you tip the carburetors over. There's one on the bottom of each one. There's an O-ring gasket that goes around the edge right here. Mine are in good shape still, so I didn't replace it. But if yours are bad, if they're flattened or if they're broken, then you got to go to the dealership and buy you a new one, or maybe you can find one on eBay. But they go right on the edge, and that seals the bottom of the carburetor. There's one thing I didn't show I've been doing. And I don't know why I didn't show it, but on the back of the carburetor, right there, there's a screw like this with a spring on it. It's the air screw. It's the air adjustment, fuel air adjustment. And what you do is you take your screwdriver and your carburetor and you turn it in. And you count how many times you turn it. Mine were at 2.5. It's really important that you get them back. You screw it in loosely, not tight, just so that it stops and not real tight. And then back it all the way back out. Take the screw out, take the spring out, and then blow compressed air through it to make sure that there's nothing clogging it too. Then when you put the screw back in, you drop the spring in first, then you drop the screw in. Then you do the same thing, you turn it all the way in until it stops. Turn it all the way in until it stops and then back it out 2.5 turns or whatever yours is at. You gotta count and make sure that it may be different on different ones. Okay, now I hooked up this hose going to the coolant that warms the carburetor. And I got both the fuel lines right here that go to the carburetor from the fuel pump. I have disconnected still. You just hook up any hoses that you might have taken off. Reconnect them now. Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, and then you gotta slide it back on all of these little boots that you loosen the clamps on, all four of them at the same time after you got all the hoses hooked up. watching. They're really good. And make sure that these clamps slide all the way on right here on every one of these carburetors. All these boots got to slide all the way on. And I got them all the way on all of them. Now I'm going to get the hex screwdriver, the T15 hex bit, and tighten up all these clamps good and snug. Carefully get all the screws tightened good and snug. All the clamps, I mean.
Mm-hmm.
No. My hex bit kind of sticks on them a little bit. Got two of them. Got two more to go. Four altogether because there's four carburetors. Make sure when you tighten them, the carburetors don't slide off at all. Because sometimes when, if the boot's not on there quite right, when you tighten it, it'll push the carburetor off.
So is the boot on there good?
Looks like I got them all real good. Wire tie that was right here holding this hose. So I'm going to put one here. To hold these drain hoses in place. And then there's supposed to be one right here too. So I'm going to replace it. They don't need to be real tight, just snug. I'm going to clip the ends off because they're way too long. And now, if you remember, I had this wire right here. Are you pointing it at this wire?
Mm-hmm.
So, I had to plug this wire back in. Make sure you don't hit the fuel lines behind it. Plug this wire back in. It only goes in one way. Pull it, make sure it's snug. And these two wires over here, they'll only go one way. This one.
It's going.
Okay, now I got to put some gas in this oil jug.
Yeah.
And it's got this on the top. I got that so it would fit on the hose. I'm going to use it to prime the carburetors. I've loosened both of the drain screws on it. Okay, gas is coming out of this one, so that carburetor is primed. You're not doing it right, Brandon. Over here.
Oh, over there. And I can actually see from right here.
Okay, now.
I see it coming.
My assistant's kind of young, so he doesn't know for good. Anyway, I loosen this one. I can see gas coming out of that one.
Yeah.
So that one's primed. And now, no more come out when I tighten that up, so I know that it's not going to flood over. The needle and seat's working properly. Now I'll go to the other carburetor. I'm not even slowing that out what I'm doing. I'm gonna put the hose on this one. The other two set of carburetors. One at the carburetor. Okay, I'm gonna loosen this one. Okay, gas is coming out the overflow. And I'm gonna loosen this one. And gas is coming out. Okay.
Turn it off.
Now I'm going to put a little bit of pressure on it. I did that on the other one. Make sure nothing comes out. Nothing's coming out of the overflow. So everything's set up right. Carburetors are primed, ready to start. Okay, now I got my ratchet so I can snug these up. Snug each one of them up. So make sure that they don't start leaking on me. on it as soon as I start it. They'll vibrate loose because I only had them finger tight. Got them all tightened up. And now, the fuel lines, got to hook onto the fuel pump. Are you putting it? Can you see it in the screen? Putting the... The bottom fuel pump runs the two carburetors on the left. Slide this clamp back on here in place. Then the two carburetors on the right go to the top carburetor. And I'll just slide that clamp into place. Up too far. About the middle is where you want it at. The vacuum pump is run by two lines that are hooked to the back of the carburetor. When the engine's running, it creates a suction which makes the vacuum or suction which makes this pump pull gas from the gas tank into the carburetors. Okay, now that we got all this carburetor, all these clamps tightened up, here, here, and here, the four clamps on the back, all the lines are hooked up, everything looks good, so we'll start it up and check for leaks. I wouldn't have primed it before with the funnel, it would have got started like that. Okay, when you put the air box back on, gotta make sure you get this hose right here hooked up. Slide the clamp back up there where it goes. And there's one on the other side. Right here, it hooks up right there, hooks up right here, front gearbox. Slide the clamp up, got that in place. I don't know if you can see it very good on the camera, but I got it on there. Okay, once you get the air box on, get all these clamps right here tight. Make sure that you got it all the way on to the carburetor so they don't leak. You don't want them sucking in dirt and stuff. Then do this little strap right here on the front of it. And then you're set to go.